County Board is now in session, Judge Belshner presiding.
Be seated. Good morning, gentlemen. Judge Belshner is here today for a motor show cause directed against the state attorney's office. She showed cause that they failed to comply with a written order of this court entered on the 20th of January. Mr. Crown, for the presence of Mr. Crown, Lee, representing the state, and Mr. Thripp, who represents himself. And once again, we later in the hearing will renew our request, or renew our offer to Mr. Thripp to have appointed counsel if he so desires. But what we're here today for is the order show cause directed to the state. I did receive yesterday your response. Please approach the podium, sir.
Yes, sir.
Mr. Crown, you're the fifth assistant state attorney in 10 months that's assigned to this case. It's been hardly a seamless transition. When I enter an order, a written order directing something to be done, I expect that it's followed. So please explain to me why you specifically, in your office in general, did not comply with the law order of this court.
Yes, Your Honor, as I put in my response, that the order in question was from January 20th, and what the order was based on, what was at the hearing, was a motion to leave to amend and a motion to dismiss. The order grants the motion to leave to amend and denies the motion to dismiss. The prosecutor who handled this before me did not see the end of your order, where you went into asking us to respond within 20 days in regards to the defendant's, defendant's affidavit of second demand for brave disclosure and contradictory nature of charging affidavit and video evidence. That hadn't been on the docket at the hearing, and we didn't see it. And I know we're impugned, or we are supposed to have knowledge and have seen the order. But Judge, we missed the order, that portion, because it hadn't been set for hearing. What had happened was we looked at the motion to dismiss as denied, and the leave to amend was granted, because that was what was at the hearing. And, you know, we just missed it. And when we got the order to show cause, we reviewed it, and we believe that this is not something that is our responsibility to get, that essentially that the defense has just as much opportunity to get the personnel files, any complaints, et cetera, of these officers. This is something that would normally not be gotten by us in discovery. Essentially, he wants the state to act as his investigator and to basically do a fishing expedition to see what might be somewhere. None of this has anything to do with this particular case. He has just as much access to it. It would have to be a public records request that would be done to the Volusia County Sheriff's Office and to the Daytona Beach Police Department. And as I put in my response, this isn't something we'd be responsible for, and that's why we filed our response. If the court says, you know, state, you do have to get this, we will certainly comply. We ask time to comply with it. Like I said, his motion wasn't for hearing, and that's why we missed it.
Understood.
You know, okay. I apologize, but we missed it.
Okay, so it's your contention that it was an oversight on your part, is that correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
Did this come to your attention, sir?
When you did the order to show cause, I realized there was something, but I had to research it and see it. As you know, I'm doing two jobs right now, and I really looked at it hard Wednesday and yesterday, and I was working on my response, and I filed it yesterday and mailed it to the defense. I provided them a copy. I would have loved to have done it earlier, Judge, but honestly, there's a lot going on.
All right. Mr. Crowley, as I said a moment ago, you, as you stand here, you're the fifth assistant state attorney in less than 10 months assigned to this case. I want you to think very carefully about what I'm about to ask you.
Okay.
That is, does the state attorney's office intend to proceed with the prosecution in this case?
Yes, sir.
So you are doing everything possible as far as you believe to bring this to a conclusion for the trial?
No, we're ready if that's what needs to happen.
We'll talk about as well, but I'm just going to clear it's your intention to proceed to trial in this case.
If necessary, we would offer a deferred prosecution agreement, but my understanding is he's not interested in any deals and doesn't want anything done, he wants to go to his trial. He's entitled to the trial. This is the trial of the century, but, you know, we think a crime is committed and he doesn't want to take a deferred prosecution agreement where there would be a guaranteed dismissal, we will certainly take the trial. That's what this decision is about, unfortunately.
Yes, sir. Well, I reviewed your response that was filed there yesterday, and I believe that you, in it, you contend that you have complied with your responsibility under the rules of discovery as well as the Brady and other subsequent decisions.
Yes, Your Honor.
So, under the rules of criminal procedure, you've complied with discovery in your view.
That's my knowledge.
Explain to me how.
We provided them everything that's in the file. We provided everything that is relevant to this case. Everything that's in our possession we have.
Is there any potentially exculpatory evidence that you possess or have access to that has not been disclosed?
I don't have access to anything that he doesn't have access to through public records that could be potentially exculpatory, to my knowledge, Judge.
What is covered under discovery rules? Is it any evidence one would seek to have someone's mortgage or, you know, personal information, or is it something that is likely to lead to admissible evidence?
Well, I think it could be things that are likely to lead to admissible evidence, Judge. In this particular case, I don't think there's anything likely to be admissible in evidence, even if the defendant, even if one of these officers had a prior bad act, that wouldn't be admissible evidence unless they have a criminal conviction.
Okay, so specific instances of prior bad acts are generally not improper impeachment. Is that what you're understanding, yes?
Yeah.
Okay, so, and that applies to any witness, including the defense or the defendant. Isn't that so?
Yes.
So we don't have trials based on someone's general character or specific instances throughout their lives. Is that correct?
Yes, sir.
So credibility and truthfulness are always at issue when someone takes a stand. We agree on that as well?
Yes, sir.
But there are specific methods of impeachment provided by the evidence code, is there not?
Yes, sir.
And you started to allude to some of those. And what are some of those ways to impeach someone?
Essentially, they have a crime involving, basically a crime involving dishonesty, or a crime of a felony conviction. The reputation of dishonesty in the community, this would be some statement.
Or prior inconsistent statement on a material issue.
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay, so I noticed in your response you did not refer to the Jackson case, Jackson versus State at 545 Southern 2nd 260. This case, generally, it's a Florida Supreme Court case from 1989, generally says that trial court erred. He claims that the trial court erred in granting a motion to limit restricting cross-examination of the detective concerning two alleged police department reprimands. The fact that the lead detective had tried to obtain search warrants after the fact and had counsel witnesses to lie on the stand. The court held, first of all, that the party may take character of a witness only by reputation, evidence referring to character regarding untruthfulness, and we know there's a specific way to do that.
Right.
Reputation in the community, that's a whole credit that has to lay. No character witness testified to the reputation in the community, nor is it specific instances of general acts of misconduct under existing law admissible in for impeachment. Further, and more importantly, and this is quoting from this Jackson case, 96.10 Florida statutes directs that a witness credibility be impeached only by conviction of crimes involving dishonesty. Clearly, a police department reprimand is not a criminal conviction as contemplated by the statute. And then they cite other cases for that proposition.
Yes, sir.
Why did you not address that in your response, sir?
I probably should have judged, I guess.
So it's your contention that Mr. Thripp is entitled to this document, these documents?
So I think he is entitled to review them, but, you know, like I said, the state attorney's office doesn't have to be the investigator for him.
Okay.
He has access to it through public records. We which is exactly what I'm having to do. I have to go to the public records request of these agencies. I don't have the personnel file, the state attorney's office doesn't have it, and has equal access to it, and that's the method. If he needs time to get that, that's fine, Judge. But we shouldn't, the state shouldn't be the ones that have to do this investigation for him on this matter.
So whether or not there is information that may be relevant to impeachment as to truthfulness or specific instances of that might be admissible on the general rule is it's not admissible.
Yeah, I don't think there's anything admissible here, Judge.
If there are, then that's for someone else to, the proponent of the evidence, to gather and.
When it's not in our possession, and he has equal access, because it's my responsibility.
All right. Anything else that you'd like to say regarding the order show cause, Mr. Conley?
No, no, other than I apologize. I didn't file a response earlier, but I didn't know of the existence of that portion of the order, because, like I said, what was set for hearing was the motion to dismiss and the motion to amend, and I apologize. No one from my office saw that, or certainly not brought to my attention. I apologize.
Mr. Thripp, please approach the podium.
Why?
Because I asked you to, sir.
I asked you to demand.
Demand.
Demand. Don't ask me to do anything.
Come
demand.
To
demand.
The podium, sir.
I want
to have indulged you.
I don't
stop speaking. I have indulged you in prior court appearances, Mr. Thripp.
Don't
this case is heading.
No
don't interrupt problem. Me again. This case is heading to trial, and I have indulged you, sir, with misdeeds in prior court appearances. Time to start following appropriate courtroom demeanor. Orally and in writing, you shall address the court as Judge Schumann or Your Honor.
No, I shall not.
No,
I shall address
you. If you interrupt me again, you're going to be held in contempt. Listen to me, and listen well. You will address the court as Judge Schumann, Your Honor, not inferior court judge B.S., orally or in writing, or your public servant, or anything other than Judge Schumann, or Your Honor. That's Mr. Cromedy. That's Deputy Lee. At all times, you will use appropriate and respectful address. I find that these forms of address are meant to be contemptuous, and I will take action if it continues. Would you like to be heard on the order to show cause, sir?
I would like you to recuse yourself because you are overtly hostile to me. You said it's my turn to talk. It's amazing how you don't answer questions and you don't let me talk. You, as a public servant, lay the law.
Call me that again and you're going to jail.
No, I said,
call me that again and you're going to jail. Is that clear, sir?
The truth is not important.
It is important, sir.
Is it?
Yes, sir. And so is decorum. So is decorum. And if you persist in this regard, you're going to, if you want to recuse me, file a motion. It has to be in writing. Feel free to do so, sir. Would you like to be heard on his order to show cause?
I don't want to go to jail. I just got this form. I haven't had time to read it. I could go through the mountain of mistakes, juvenile mistakes, made by you, one after the other. You're charging me with a crime that allegedly happened in 2014. You're dating it 2016. You misspell my name. Yeah, please smirk about it. Judge Schumann, I don't want to be indulged. I want you to honor your oath, which you refuse to do.
Correct.
I want you to stop apologizing. You don't know your job? We understand.
Don't address your remarks to him.
Why not?
Because that's improper. That's improper. No, sir. You address your remarks to me, sir.
Who's my
address your remarks to me. That is not proper courtroom decorum. You will refrain from that comment.
Right, right. Are we in trial posture?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Do I have a right to face my accuser at
you
my
do
trial?
You do that at trial by, under the Sixth Amendment, through cross-examining the witnesses that he presents.
So I don't have a right to question him?
No, sir. No, sir.
Okay. So you can't question. There's something I can say. You're now holding me this close to a jail cell.
That's correct.
Because I refer to you by what you refer to in the...
Do it again, and
why?
See what happens.
Why?
I implore you, sir.
Why?
To
I
comply with...
I have to comply. I'm here. You changed the date of the last minute.
I did.
Holding my jail.
Not true.
I believe it. I believe that's my opinion. lock me up in my opinion, I believe this is calculated, to get me in trouble because you